See. Hi, Kathy.
Hi, Marco.
Welcome back to QuadJacks.
Thank you. How you guys doing? Good day,
doing,
huh?
Doing great, Kathy. And I just want to say before I let the two guys take over the interview, your picture is up right now, and just for you, Kathy, I made the background saying breaking news in purple.
I see it. Purple. Good. Good job. I told you guys this was going to happen today. Did you believe me or not? Come on. Tell me the truth. Did you believe me?
I did.
I did, too.
Marco
did, and Nemat did not.
Yeah, Nemat was the naysayer here.
I knew this was going to happen. I knew this for a while.
Kathy, how did you know?
I know people that know people that know people.
All right.
So, I heard about this for a while.
Okay.
So, but that's great. I mean, I'm very happy because I'm not a big fan of Full Tilts. I'm not a big fan of Ray Bertar or Howard Letterer, but I think it's good for everybody, so I'm happy.
No, that's very good. That's very good, Kathy. I mean, you've been pretty outspoken about Full Tilt Poker.
No, you think so?
since Black Friday. I mean, what is your? You know, I'm curious to ask you this, Kathy. I mean, it's been 15 to 16 months. I'm still not sure which. But, a lot of people aren't even are not even waiting right now to begin commenting on who are we going to keep blaming after this? You know, Steve was from Wicked Chops was just on saying, don't.
Well, it's obvious that Ray Bertar is still going to get all the blame. I mean, well, most of the blame as far as the DOJ going after him criminally. Mm-hmm. Whether Howard and Ferguson go after them criminally, I mean, it's not clear. You know, I mean, they might get off the hook. But I guess Ray Bertar has been set up for the fall guy all along, so I guess he's still the fall guy. I don't think anything's really changed there. Howard's going to come back and say, see, I told you everything was going to be okay. We told you we'd get back to you, and there we are.
Do you think so?
I think Howard's going to issue a statement sometime in the near future. And I haven't talked to Howard. I did try calling him. He didn't take my call. Not quite sure why. I think he's going to issue a statement saying, see, everything's okay. Full Tilt is back. Everyone's getting their money. And I think you guys should, forgive me and move on.
Do you think people will forgive him, though, Kathy? Like, after what he's done and the delaying of this whole process for the whole year?
I think it's going to be hard. I think that if Howard actually does show his face in mainstream stream poker tournaments, that he's going to have a rude awakening that he's still not well-liked.
I wonder what gave him that impression.
I think Annie Duke had a similar experience at the World Series of Poker. She came and played some events. And I think that she was surprised at how much animosity or how much venom she received from certain people.
Yeah.
It shouldn't come as a surprise to them, because they screwed people over. I mean, Annie Duke and Jeffrey Pollock had stuff with Epic Poker League, and they messed up on that side. So at the end of the day, it just comes down to them thinking they're untouchable. Like, they've got massive egos, and they just can't see past it.
Well, that's been part of the problem all along with Full Tilt and with Howard Letterer. I mean, to be quite honest, I think I've shared this with many people in the past, including QuadJacks. Howard was very arrogant, and his arrogance controlled a lot of his behavior, and his arrogance and his greed led to all of this, in my opinion. So it seems to me that the problems that he's going to be facing ahead are still based on that, and yet he still doesn't quite realize, that he was not doing the right things, that he was arrogant, that he was greedy, that he made a lot of mistakes. I mean, maybe he realizes he made some mistakes, but I don't think that either Annie or Howard really blame themselves for all the failures and all the problems that have come to light over the near recent past.
Kathy, I'm wondering a lot has happened since Black Friday. We've learned a lot of things. I would say, many of us, maybe we've been proven wrong about a couple of things we may have used to believe or we were prejudiced about. I'm curious, is there anything that you've changed your mind about since Black Friday or kind of taken a slightly different view in light of everything that's happened?
Sure. I've learned a lot. I mean, I can't, I've been on top of this, as some of my Twitter followers probably know, for quite a while. And there was a lot of things that came to light that I had no knowledge of. And I've come to believe that Ray Bitar probably was the worst of all of them. I mean, I've come to believe that Chris Ferguson probably really didn't know as much as he should have, and that Howard Lederer, he still has some friends in the industry that defend him, and I've talked to those people. They don't think he's such a bad guy. Maybe he didn't start off trying to be an asshole and rip everybody off and cause all these problems. He probably didn't. But that doesn't excuse the fact that he was arrogant and greedy and made a lot of mistakes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well. Do you... yes, I think like you were saying before, I saw you tweet that you tried to call Howard.
I did. I actually did. I called him from my home, from my cell phone, so he probably knows that I called him.
When's the last time you
tried? This is the first time I've ever tried to call Howard. This is the first time I've ever called him, ever, in my life.
Ever in your life?
Ever in my life. I never called him once. And I decided to reach out today to make peace and say, we forgive you, Howard. Everything's okay. Come on back. And then have somebody attack him and say, oh, wait, I thought everything was okay. No, I don't really want to know to attack Howard. I mean, to be honest, personally, I had a lot of negative feelings towards Howard. And probably part of me liked seeing him go down, you know, because of my relationship with him, which I never had a relationship with him. We didn't like each other. It was clear. He never wanted me on Full Tilt. I never wanted to be on Full Tilt because Howard was an asshole and he was arrogant and I didn't want to deal with him. He didn't want to deal with me. So actually, in the long run, he did me a favor. But at the time, it seemed like he was just trying to use his power to manipulate people and control things, which I really didn't like.
Yeah, well, it's...
I don't think he'll ever be. I don't think. Well, speaking from my perspective, I was never too keen on Howard Lerner. Anyways, like watching him on, like all the TV programs, he just had something about him that made me just want to punch his face. Not because of like his poker skills and anything like that. Just the way he spoke, and I don't think that like even though people will say, "Oh, it's okay," like thanks for doing this deal. I don't think like people will say it's okay. We've accepted it, but we're still not going to accept you as a person because what you've done and the way you are and the way you've treated people is just totally unforgivable.
I think people kissed Howard's ass because he had the paycheck and he had the power. He had the money and he had the power. I think at this point, people aren't going to be kissing Howard's ass because he has no power anymore. And, you know, I think that that's going to be a rude awakening. And, yeah, he was smug, arrogant, treated people poorly, and they put up with it because he had the power to write the check. Or not write the check, or blackball you, or, you know, so a lot of people kissed his ass, and I never did, and I'm glad I never did, and I'm not going to start now, but now that all this is over, I can actually call him on the phone and say, what's up, buddy, you know, tell us the story.
Is that, did you actually mean to make peace with him when you called him earlier today, Kathy?
No, I didn't, oh. I didn't think he would do that. I mean, honestly, I thought there was a zero chance that he would answer the phone, and a zero chance he would call me back, but I decided that, you know what, when Epic started, Andy called me up on the phone and said, hi, this is Andy Duke, give me a call back. So I decided to do the same thing to Howard, because everything is fine.
What do you think, like,
I think you should keep calling, Kathy. Keep calling.
Yeah. Keep pestering that son of a bitch.
You guys want to call him? Maybe he'll answer your call.
Yes. I'll bet he will.
He would love to speak to you guys.
What were you going to say, Matt?
I was just going to say about the fact that now this is all over, do you think that the poker community will kind of get back on its feet, so to speak, and continue to grow as it has been growing for the past God knows how long now? Do you think it will get
online
better?
Online poker? What's the question?
Like, just poker in general. Like, do you think online poker will get better and
it's going to get a lot better. In 5 years, it's going to be the best it's ever been in 5 years. Pokerstars will be back in 3 to 5 years in the U.S.
No, that's good to hear.
These are the words of PokerCat.
Exactly. To hear from a good source.
What makes you believe that, Kathy?
Oh, because I know people that know people that know people.
Oh,
so, I mean,
right.
That is my belief,
yes.
Obviously. Well, you know, it's based on a few things. I mean, I've done some research, and it's my belief that, I mean, obviously, interest rates going to come first, and then the casinos, and then PokerStars is good, which they're seeming to be good, that they have a chance of getting back in the market. If not, as a standalone, their own brand, somebody else will take over their software. You know, it's too good. The software is too good, and the name is too good, and they have too much money not to get back into the U.S. at some point in some capacity. And that's my belief. Of course, I don't have any inside information.
No.
Would you ever consider, if PokerStars ever offered you a sponsorship for like tournaments, would you ever represent them? After
would I ever work for PokerStars?
Yeah.
Is that the question? If they offered me what?
Like, if they offered you sponsorship for tournaments or sponsorship for like programs they put on, would you agree to it? Even though after everything they've done?
I mean, I don't know. I mean, it depends on what the offer is, obviously. But if Full Tilt contacted me and said, "You want to wear Full Tilt?" Even though they're owned by PokerStars, I've never worn Full Tilt, and I'm proud of that fact. And I don't want to wear Full Tilt. PokerStars actually did the right thing. I mean, they never gave me a Team PokerStars deal or anything like that, but I still respect them, and I have worn PokerStars patches before, and if they offered me the right deal, I would certainly consider it. The reason why I never had a long-term deal with PokerStars in the past was varied, but basically they didn't offer me enough. You know, I probably would have done it if they had offered me enough in the past.
Mm. That's interesting.
I don't think you and I work very well together, Nemat. Keep talking. We have over different each other and stuff.
No, we got to work on it, Marco. We'll get there.
Hey, Kathy, I got a question.
You know what? I'll tell you the truth. Let me just tell you one thing about my relationship with PokerStars, because I wasn't sponsored by PokerStars. I had a short term deal with them many, many years ago when they first started out, like daily deals or something like. You know, it was just the deals are much different back then. They basically paid you a few hundred dollars a day to wear a hat, but. When I made the final table, a televised final table of the WSOP Pot Limit Hold'em event, somebody came up to me and said, "Oh, we already got you a deal with Full Tilt. You know, everyone was wearing Full Tilt, and they said, this is the deal, and, you know, all you have to do is sign here." And I said, "No, I'm not signing any deal with Full Tilt. You know, if I'm going to do a deal with anybody, it's going to be PokerStars." So I knew at that moment, even way before Black Friday, that I didn't want to wear a Full Tilt, and I was willing to wear PokerStars at that time, for sure.
Sweet.
Kathy? Question from KevMath.
Yes.
Have you already RSVP'd to Howard's party?
You know, I heard about his July 4th party. Did anybody else hear about this?
Nope.
Well, we're hearing, I heard about that party, but we're hearing that he's going to have a party for, you know, today's news.
Oh, I'm sure I'm not invited.
You want to crash it with Marco and I?
Do you know his address?
Yeah.
If I had a plane, I would do it.
I think we should stop by, Kathy, or at least try to stop by. And like you said, men
fans. I would go. I don't think he'll let us in. But at this point, confronting Howard would not be on the bottom of my list.
Hey, Marco.
Which at one point I'm sure it would have been.
Marco, what do you think? Maybe you can hold the camera this time, and Kathy can do the interview.
Well, it wouldn't be the first time we've. No, I'm here.
Okay. Wouldn't be the what?
Well, it wouldn't be the first time that we showed up at one of Howard's parties.
And KevMath brings up another good point. He said we should also bring Chainsaw and Raymond Davis. So I think it'd be a good crew. Well, Kathy, I mean, for you. I'm very pleased to hear you say what you've said about Full Tilt and that you're proud not to have worn any of that stuff. I think you made the right decisions.
I mean, yeah. I mean, obviously, the average person that wore it didn't have any idea or didn't have any of the beliefs that I did, you know. And there's nothing wrong with that. But you know, they really did disappoint me, Full Tilt, in a lot of ways, especially Team Full Tilt. And to be honest, I've been very disappointed with the poker world, just you know, in general, because Full Tilt Team pros were looked up to, and when it came time to get the checks, they were more than happy to wear the patches. And when it came time to stand up and say and do the right thing, they were nowhere to be found.
Yeah, and I kid that we're going to crash this party, Kathy. We can at least try to call at least one more time.
I'll call him. He's not answering my phone calls. I don't happen to have his address, although I'm sure I know people that have it. But that would be pretty ballsy just to show up at his front door. I'm afraid I'd get shot.
He's got it. He's behind a gated community, so it's not like we can just walk up to his door anyway. But anyways, it'd be fun. We can dream, can't we?
We can get the gate code.
You know, if I can get serious for a moment, like the thing is. You know, given how liberal and informal we are here at QuadJacks, like, if I were Howard Lederer, I know we fucked with him, but if I were Howard Lederer and I had to do, like, one show or do one interview, I'd probably come here and be like, you know what, I'm just going to go to QuadJacks. They're going to let me do or say, you know, whatever the hell I want without constraints. And, yeah, that guy was like all, you know.
Well, maybe we can give Annie a call. Maybe she can get Howard to call into the show. What do you think about that?